What?
Boy, I don't think they're ready for this.
These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. Pull up on them and it look nice. Look nice.
These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future. These moves looking real nice in the future.
Yeah, we look nice. Future looking nice. We don't need to tell them twice.
Here comes the future.
Yeah, we look nice. Future looking real nice. We don't need to tell them twice.
Here comes the future.
Hello and welcome to the Liberty A-League Highlights Show. The long wait is over and women's football is back for the 15th edition of this great league. Western United are the latest team to join the Liberty A-League and they recruited some serious quality. The headline acts, current Matilda Chloe Legazzo and World Cup winner Jess McDonald. They welcome reigning champions Melbourne Victory for their inaugural game. Calling the action is Pakua Frimpong and Grace Gill.
Challenge there by Melina Reyes. Bounces around a bit. Foul there. High boots. And early bruises of an A-League women's season. Back there. Robes on the ball. Former Victory player last season and made the move across to Western. Francesca Umana crosses it in, hovers around in a dangerous area as we see Adriana Taranto, and Hannah Keane takes a strike at that just wide of the goals. But I'm telling you, she's played against them. She feels good. She's playing probably one of the best players for Western this half. Strong shot there from Adriana Taranto, but always wide of that goal. But the Taranto sisters, they have formerly played for Victory before, but they're great strikers of the ball and can score a mean goal from outside the box. Lee's going to take this set piece here, plays it to the back to Keane, but just couldn't get enough purchase on that. And opportunity here for Sydney. Early goal there from Western United, and who else for Jess McDonald? The American international gets her side first goal in this competition, and you can see what it means to this group of players and these fans.
Well, who else but Jess McDonald, the guest player here for Western United against her former club, her former side in Melbourne Victory, as we have another look at this finish. Melbourne Victory failed to clear this one, failed to get it out of the danger area.
As we see Western here with Keane, tries and almost curls that in. Betty Goad beats Sydney Cummings there, an opportunity here, plays it into to Catherine Zimmerman. As the ball plays into Zimmerman there, but Hillary Beal just comes out in time to collect that ball. Gazzo on the ball here. Whips that in, and the wind almost brought that down. I think Casey Dumont saw that, was a little bit more scared the closer that ball got to her.
history made off the bat. What a way to start, knocking the champions off their perch in the opening game and drawing a great crowd along to watch them do so. Brilliant to see. Let's head to Queensland now for Brisbane Roar and Newcastle Jets at Perry Park. Your commentator is Campbell Johnson.
It's been 1,847 days since Newcastle got an opening day win, and Griffith just goes wide. And a golden opportunity for the women in white and gold. The American almost putting it away there for Newcastle. And switching off were the Jets. Potential foul there. Connors does well. Evades two. One on one. Teeing it up. Hecker just going wide. Crummer. They open it. The first goal of the season for the Brisbane Roar. Goes to the Matilda. Larissa Crummer. Asleep at the wheel were Newcastle Jets. Defence all at sea. And the Brisbane Roar able to pounce. Shea Connors just tees it up here. And Mariel Hecker does the same, unselfish. Connors. Marked by Clough. Connors does well. Delivering now. And put away in her return to the Brisbane Roar. Sian Fryer. Able to punish the Jets and make it three before halftime in what could be a tough day in the office for Ash Wilson's side. Happened and did well, but still the Jets moving forward. Griffith opening up the angle, striking, palmed onto the bar from handcuff. And offside is the call from an end product perspective for the American forward. Now, Brodigan. Saved by handcuff, dives back on top. And the best chance of the half for the Jets. And ball in now. Konjarski going around handcuff, has to be a foul. Will it be more for Hensley handcuff? A one-on-one and an instant impact. Agnew buries it for Newcastle. Is the comeback on? Handcuff going the wrong way. Well struck. Agnew. Deep delivery. Headed down. Handcuff saving. Makes its way in. Not enough on it. And what's the decision? We saw a corner disallowed in the first half. And Konjarski writhing in pain.
The third and final game on Saturday afternoon is Canberra United up against Perth Glory, two sleeping giants of Australian football hoping to improve on their last campaigns. Calling the action is Taryn Haydo and Leah Blaney.
Won the ball again here, pressing so high. Jale on the edge of the area decides to play it back to Wu. Wu with that right foot and just over the crossbar. Ops to play back to Ma. Over the top, Flannery. And a shot on her left, and Langman called into evasive action. Once more, tipped over the bar. The returning Nikki Flannery making waves on her return from her ACL injury. Ma to deliver. Into the penalty area, in swinging corner, and it's in the back of the net! Canberra United, to all of their early pressure, have scored in the Liberty A-League to go 1-0 up against Perth Glory off a fantastic Grace Mark corner. Master Antonio whips the corner in. Poorly cleared by Canberra, and a shot from the edge of the area. Hannah Lowry! Chloe Lincoln with a fantastic diving save. Her first action of the game. Corner in, and it's... Is it in the back of the net? The Perth Glory players half celebrated. It came off the post, and it is in. Perth Glory equalise from a corner. And we flagged that corners were dangerous. Liz Anton has only ever scored against Canberra, and she scores again. It's Hannah Lowry. Hits it long, finds the feet of Abby Green, who tries to square it for Coleman, but too close to Lincoln.
And that's actually a fantastic little dink pass in by Lowry. She's got space in behind. It's appropriately weighted. Beautiful ball.
Grace Ma charging forward for Canberra. Still Ma to Pezza Milivojevic on her left, and it's in! On debut for Canberra United. Scores her first goal in the Liberty A-League Women's on her left, and Canberra 2-1 up.
And it's a fantastic little ball by Grace Ma. The timing of her release, she commits her defender. That's her outside of her left foot, and a great finish by young Vesna Milivojevic on debut for Canberra, as you touched on.
Perth advancing now. Hinson into the penalty area. Sierra Hinson cuts it back to Coleman, who scores, and Perth a level through their two American signings. Gabriella Coleman on debut has leveled it up for Perth. 2-2 here at McKellar Park.
And as you can see, the influence of Hinson, she's able to use her body. She gets in front of McComsky, who really has to do a better job of staying on her feet.
Join us after the break as we wrap up the opening round of the Liberty A-League. Welcome back to the Liberty A-League Highlights Show. New look Wellington Phoenix finally get to play in front of their own fans after spending last season based in Wollongong, and a record crowd turned out to welcome them as they took on Melbourne City at Sky Stadium.
chance at the other end, perhaps, for Melbourne City now. A real chance for them. And it all, unfortunately, fizzled out there for Briley Henry. She, I think, got caught in two minds between crossing and shooting. In the end, it didn't have to require a save from Bree Edwards. Bit of possession for Wellington, but it's given up, and now a chance for City to come again through Polisina. Lovely ball into the path of Rojas. Is it the first time shot? No, she squares it. Real chance for Melbourne here. Off the post it is from Amina Erkic. A real chance for Melbourne City to open the scoring. The goal at her mercy, and she hit the woodwork. Taylor's come out of the line, and Rojas is going to run. Gives it up to Gjelic towards the far side. Another chance for Melbourne now. Great save by Edwards. And cleared away by the Wellington defence. Brianna Edwards that time keeping the sheet clean. Daniela Gjelic doing well there to halt the attack. And now here's Rojas with a bit of an opportunity. She's all by herself at the moment, and tracked all the way by Taylor, who's done well to go stride for stride with the Chilean. A bit of a shove there, and Rojas has got away from Taylor. Danger here as the shot comes towards the far post and tucked in by Briley Henry. Melbourne City opened the scoring. Briley Henry, the teenager, has tucked it away, but put it down to the industry and the skill of Maria Rojas, and Melbourne City lead. Briley Henry, the 19-year-old, and it's got a bit of a spring in their step as Polisina now looks to double the trouble into Rojas. Rojas, a lovely turn. Rojas, a lovely goal. Melbourne City go bang, bang. And Maria Rojas created the first, but that was all her own work for the second. Lovely close control from the Chilean striker. And all of a sudden, Melbourne City are two to the good. Any break on here, if they can get the construction of the passes right. There are five Melbourne City players forward in this attack, and that one's gone in too. I'm pretty sure that went in at the first time of asking. Rojas has made sure, but I think that's gone in. Flag is up on the far side though, perhaps for offside, but I think that went in the first shot, didn't it?
Might be a bit of player interference, I think, here. I think it's Polisina with the shot, and maybe Rojas just blocking the eyesight there of Edwards in goal.
Just almost impossible to get the ball off, and she's gone down for the penalty. It always looked like one when Rojas went down. She set up a goal, she has scored a goal, and now she has won her side a penalty. Polisina, and a hand to it from Brianna Edwards, but it's found its way in, and City now three clear of Wellington with just 25 minutes to go, and the 3 points look safe for the visitors. Gjelic. It's Polisina again, looks up and curls one! Brianna Polisina, a brace for the captain today. And this is looking really impressive for Melbourne City. It's getting a little bit ugly for the Wellington Phoenix, but Brianna Polisina has curled in a fourth goal for the visitors.
Nice bit of play or interchange here from City, and just giving Polisina a little bit too much room inside that 18-yard box. She puts the ball onto her right foot and then curls the effort into the back post and puts City up 4-0 here in Wellington.
Melbourne City showing absolutely no mercy as they look to get back into the silverware this season. The final match of the round comes from South Australia. Last year's surprise packet, Adelaide United host the runners-up from the last two seasons, Sydney FC.
Holmes, good close control from Dylan Holmes, fancies a shot, and it took a deflection. It's out for a corner, and Dylan Holmes, who scored plenty of goals on this ground for Adelaide City in the NPL season, is able to win a corner kick. Condon Shades of a handball. Play continues. And the home fans appreciate the run here of Condon. Able to breeze around McLean. And now what follows? The pass out to the right. Chelsea Dorber on a tight angle. Wirtz waits in the middle. Left for Condon. And Emily Condon not able to finish the move that she started.
Oh, that is a seriously enterprising run there from Emily Condon to start that way back in her own defensive half and just drive through the midfield.
Courtney Vine, starting very deep over on the right, has only had flashes in this game. Certainly hasn't been the commanding presence that one might expect Courtney Vine to be at this level of the game. And now, right on cue, is drawing a good save out of Annalie Grove. And that is what Courtney Vine is capable of. Ball in the box. Here's Dorber. Just wide. And the grandstand was going up. They thought that was the opener for Adelaide. And Chelsea Dorber, her first sighter on goal, is swept wide. Vine looks up. Hawksby at the edge of the box. Here's Princess Abini. Totally unmarked Abini and shoots at the keeper. And just when it looked like it was about to be Princess Abini's day, the finish wasn't there.
Well, that is a clear-cut opportunity for Sydney FC. A shake of the head from Princess Abini.
Winning the ball back. And then gives it to Sasaki and a little clip on the way through. Referee didn't see a foul and so Courtney Vine will sprint away. And Adelaide on their heels backtracking. Vine to Abini. Princess Abini cutting in, shrugs off one defender. Abini shooting, deflected. And it goes wide, and the deflection may have been crucial in that.
That's better from Abini. Much more confidence behind that shot. She's dropped into her right foot there to try and get the shot away. The deflection suggested she just ran into an offside position, but she found herself in some really good space out in that right-hand side position.
Hawksby sends it out to Vine on the right. Into the last 10 minutes of regulation. Sydney FC have been on top for some time now. Vine looks up at a wall of Adelaide players. Goes back to Hawksby. Crossfield ball. Dorber helping out in defence. Only as far as Hunter. And that one was straight at the keeper.
Easy work there for Annalie Grove once more. But this is good anticipation from Sarah Hunter there. It's dropped right into a nice position.
Tonkin deflected by Abini. Abini now goes back to Hunter. Turned around and saw Amelia Murray blocking one passing channel, so opted for Nat Tobin instead. Sends a crossfield ball to Vine. Now Stanage Floody, the 16-year-old. What can she do? Plays it to the 17-year-old Dos Santos. And Janaya Dos Santos back to Hawksby. Hawksby to Abini. Just bringing the ball under control. Abini with the shot. And skimming off the turf. It required a good save. Getting behind the ball from Grove, who's starting to go through a fair bit of work now.
Just looking to get the ball on her preferred right foot is Abini.
Green inside. Tonkin. Great challenge on Hawksby. And the ball fell to Westland. First touch in Adelaide colours. Gets it over to Dorber. Dorber with a raking long ball and a flick out from Murray! And Amelia Murray has scored in the Liberty A-League for the first time! And what a time to do it!
And what a goal! What a ball across from Chelsea Dorber. Time stood still there for Amelia Murray. The confidence Adrian Stenter has had in these youngsters. But this ball was superb. Puts indecision into the mind of Jada Wyman. And Amelia Murray, she rises above. That is a brilliantly finished header.
And what about the shock on her face that the flick header worked? And the young woman who came through the South Australia NTC program, originally from Albury Wodonga, and into the game today to score in the A-League Women's for the very first time. And the whistle goes! Adelaide United, with a late winner, grab the 3 points on the opening weekend.
And a late goal wins it for the Reds at home. That's it from round one of the Liberty A-League. Join us next week for more action.